teacher, he's a lecturer in mythology, teaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is the continuation of Christianity, and I can explain parables in deep, deep details. But so far, no customers. Customers will arise after 2018, when there will be a lot of tribulation in the world. Then they will seek God. When they are living comfortably, they don't want to know it. And it is not my intention that people should suffer, but that is the way it is. You know, when in 1947 we had the partition of India, then people became God oriented and started to go to worship, prayer and other things, you know, which did not count because they had no gospel. Without gospel, you cannot live peacefully. Gospel is a double-edged sword, and it works. Bring you peace, bring others peace. Here I'm doing a gospel of St. Luke 10, verse 38-42. Jesus entered a village where a woman whose name was Martha welcomed him. Now Jesus, you know, had a talk with Mary Magdalene before. She was serving, doing the job of prostitution to upkeep the family. They were poor. Lazarus was begging. And so she thought, you know, let me also, you know, earn something for the family. So they were poor people. And that's why she took on the profession of prostitution. As today some women, you can see them married, but they do it, you know, for the extra income. And when she was doing this profession, she was sensible. She was not stupid. Twice born, because she met customers and they treated her, and this thing she learned from them, you know, how their mentality is. They are very clever. And she also then understood it. She became twice born. And Jesus met her and told her, so far you remain faithful to Abraham, whose land you are living in, he will look after you, he will feed you. Abraham, then his God, Yahweh, who brought him here and gave him this promised land, and they will look after you, both of them. So you don't need to worry. So far you are faithful to Abraham. Remember, the John the Baptist called the temple priest the brood of vipers, because they were turning people, tribal people, say Judah tribe people, they were turning them into Jew outwardly of appearance, not of the heart. A Jew is one who is inwardly heart and not outwardly of the physical body, but they were making them super bastard fanatic devils. And so far they were turning the other people who came to worship there and were influenced by their shawl and appearance and their rituals. They were taken away with them, singing and all that. So they say, we want to become a Jew also. Oh yes, you can become it. You have to get yourself circumcised. Circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac. Only the sons born of the Isaac, they can be circumcised, nobody else. Today you see them in Iran, India, Aryan race people. What they have to do with Abraham? Nothing. He was Semitic race. So he is fake. You know, I have told in my previous video that how Stephen went to the temple to warn them not to make faith sons of Abraham, but that was their business. So they were grinding their teeth and killed him. And now they are going to kill them. And they are the ones who are the staunch enemy of these Jewish people. They created them, so they will now suffer at their hands. So Mary Magdalene, being twice born, she listened to Jesus and stopped doing that. And then she was having a more religious side because she was poor. The poor are more attached to God than the rich. Rich are comfortable, they have nothing to worry. They are too comfortable to think of God. Poor are always, thinking of God in the morning, even every time you think of God, because there's a hard life for them. The rich people, they fleece them, squeeze them, greed. They take money out of them every time, and so they suffer. How the rich become? By fleecing the poor. That's as simple as that. So Martha, she was once born. She was not that clever. So that's why she was told, stay at home and I go for earning more extra income. So Mary, then listened to Mary who sat beside the Lord. Or Martha, she was once born. Being once born, she only know that he is a big man, he can perform miracles, this and that. So she called him a Lord. As you can see, these once born people in churches, if you tell them the Lords have slaves and Father has sons, it is right to call God Father than Lord. No. We will call him Lord. Lord is the better word. Even Jesus, they will call him Lord out of affection. Not that they know it, because they love him. So calling him, this is what the once-born people will do. They will go by what pleases them. Martha, once-born, burdened with much serving, Mary, who sat beside the Lord at his feet, listening to him speak. Martha, once born, burdened with much serving, came to him and said, Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me? So you can see, that she was being burdened with the work. And she was more worried, she's not serving. I'm doing hard work. She's just sitting there, idle there. By myself, to do the serving, tell her to help me. That means, tell her to share my rich, routines, what we call them. Our anointed elder brother, and not the Lord of the Messianic Jews, said to her in reply, Martha, Martha, you are anxious. That is what the once born people are, that when we die, what will happen to them? Will we go to heaven or hell? The priest, frightened them. If you don't pay me, or you don't do what I tell you to do, you may go to hell. And that is what the priest was doing during the time of Jesus. So Martha, she was just worried, with these worldly things. You are anxious and worried about many worldly things. There's need of only one thing, which is spiritual prayers that count in the court of our Father. When you die, only those count when you meet Father. Then he will tell you, what prayers have you bought for me? Gospel prayers. Mary had chosen the better part, and it will not be taken from her. Taken from her, that means our tree is rest where our heart is. Gospel is written over your heart and not in the book. So that's why Jesus said, unless you eat the flesh of Jesus and drink the blood of Christ, you have no part in me. Eating the flesh of Jesus means what came out of the mouth of Jesus. This mouth is of midger. And same Jesus spoke, and what came out of his mouth, our ears is the mouth. We should listen it by our ears, take it to our heart and not into the stomach. Digest it and then ponder over it, and next time we bring it out after understanding and explain in details what Christ Jesus has said. But that is called drinking the blood of Christ or carrying the cross. Remember, if I went to Germany and over there was a kitchen dog, and I went to the politician's tent and I told them, you know, not a single Jew died during your you can't say like that. If you say like that, then you could be put into jail, you know. I said, okay, go ahead and do it. I told him, not a single Jew died, but people of Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, tribal people were born, tribal people died. But politicians, they are hypocrites. Everything that comes from their mouth should be sugar-coated. A priest in the church, we are royal priests. Royal priests are different from priests. These priests in the church, they are worse than the rabbis from the yoke of which Christ Jesus set us free. Those rabbis, they were responsible to their congregation. They won't run away like these priests in church. Somewhere else he find a better church and better job, money, he will just resign and go there. Those rabbis won't go. They stay with their congregation, whether they are poor or rich. And they were responsible to them. These are irresponsible. So in them is fulfilled Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, that the situation will become worse than before the arrival of Jesus. And that is what it is today. And you need to be royal priest. Royal priests are different. They give to the church, they don't take out of the church. That will not apply to flesh, the opposite apply to spiritual field. The moral teachers are priests, rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees, John the Baptist. They were priests, so they were taking the money, tithe, from the people. Whereas in Christ Jesus, as St. Paul has stressed, that I have given to the church, haven't taken anything out of the church. We opposite, we give, we don't take from the people. We give to the church and not take anything out of the church. As you go into a sick temple, you see them, people bringing food, everything. They give to the church, they don't take it out of the church. So the whole situation will become clear to you once you become a independent, solitary, and you can think logically. Once you think logically, you will brew logo, and logo is his word. When you brew it, then no book can find it. It is received through revelation of our Father. Unless he reveals to you, you can't have it. Simple fact, this one, you know, I have written, let anybody answer. If you find somebody who can answer this one, he is twice more. If he can't, he is a super donkey carrying holy books. So you will find many of these super donkeys in the churches, and those carrying Bible under their armpit, If you ask them question, they open the Bible, they keep on giving cross reference, this reading that, and they themselves have no idea what they are reading. But they impress the people. So they are called super donkeys carrying holy books. That is Christ Nanak, the second Jesus sent in India. Our Father God blesses you.